Hey guys, it's Leanna and I'm here today to rant about The Haunting of Hill House. If you've never heard of The Haunting of Hill House, it's a classic horror novel. I think, pretty sure, it's a horror novel, not a thriller. Well, regardless, it's considered a classic of its genre, whatever that genre is. And Netflix did recently adapt this. I haven't seen the Netflix show, from what I gather. The Netflix show follows totally different characters in a totally different time period and is very loosely based on this. So, I don't know. Maybe I'll watch it, because maybe I'll like it better than this, if it's nothing like this. I was led to believe that, well, for one, it would be great, because it's a classic, but also that it's very, very creepy and dark and chilling and scary. And I don't really read horror, so I was fully prepared to be, like, extra scared, because it's not something I generally read, so my tolerance would be, in theory, even lower. I mean, I read grimdark, but that's not the same thing. So I expected to be thoroughly creeped out and blown away by its amazingness and its scariness, and neither happened. And I will be non-spoiler briefly now, and that was kind of it, aka it sucks. So the most of this video will have spoilers in it because my reasons for disliking it are pretty spoilery. But the non-spoiler section reasons is, again, that it's not scary and that it doesn't really ever, I guess that's kind of spoilery. I mean, basically, like, it doesn't really explain anything. And I hate that. I felt really unsatisfied and not remotely impressed and not remotely scared reading this. A lot of people love it. It is a classic. So maybe don't take my word for it. But if you, like me, picked it up and were like, this is gonna be amazing because it's considered amazing, and you did not feel that it was, and you would like to commiserate, well then stay tuned because we about to get into spoilers. Now, I did give this book 3 stars. The main reason being, it did a few things well. That being, the prose is pretty good. It's pretty atmospherically told. I could picture everything very well. It was told in a way that was very readable. I had a sense for, again, who everyone kind of was. Not exactly, and I'll get into that in a second because that is part of my problem with it, but like overall, like it was executed in a, like, I feel like part of the craft is telling the story in a way that makes it good. But I just mean, like, the sentences are well constructed and, like, it's told in a logical order. I don't know, like, it seems like that side of things is fine. And then, if this book had not been a horror novel, if this never purported to be a horror novel, and we took out some of the supernatural elements, and we just made this a story about some people who are staying at this house, and one of them is losing their mind, and that's what this is about, I think this book would actually be really good if that's what it was about. But that's not what it's about, and for that reason, it's terrible. What do I mean by that? So again, this is the spoiler section, so I'm kind of gonna assume you may have read this, so I apologize if I'm not super clear on things. But so basically, this man who is interested in studying the supernatural, he has a degree in anthropology because he thinks that a degree in anthropology will lend him credulity in these studies. And on the surface of that, at first I was like, anthropology, and I was like, wait a minute, what do you mean a degree in anthropology means you can now study haunted houses? You're making anthropologists look stupid. Anyway, so I went from being like excited to like super not excited that's his background. And he's interested in Hill House, which is known for being haunted, and he invites to go to the house 2 young women who are like somehow connected to the supernatural, and that's like so thin, his reasons for that. It's just like so bizarre. And then he's required to have with him the heir who's supposed to inherit Hill House, just because like they won't rent him the house without him being there. So he's there because. And then later on, the main guy, the professor, like the doctor of anthropology, his wife shows up and brings a friend. So that's our group of people staying at the house. And the main guy, he writes to these young women and invites them to come to the house. And, like, just that on its own is a reason I hate this book, because the way he singled them out was basically that, like, it had been in the papers, it was kind of somehow generally known, that one of them was known for being kind of a mind reader, and the other one had experienced something supernatural. I think it was something telekinetic, something like that. I don't know. It was strange. And for that reason alone, he wrote to them and asked them to come to the house. And they accepted. So him asking them, it was weird. And then them accepting is unlikely and weird. Now, they don't meet him before they go to the house. They just pack up and show up at the house where they meet him for the first time. And like, why? I would never in the history of ever do anything like that. At least not without like meeting first and being like, you wrote to me and said you'd like me to go with you to this house and then go together, like, not actually go all the way to the fucking house. Like, it's just as a premise, I'm like, who would do this and who would expect that to work? Like, why would he think they would go for that? If I was him, I would offer to meet these people and interview them first. I would want to, because I'm going to be spending time with them in a house, like, overnight. Like, you'd more to vet them more than just, like, I heard they experienced something supernatural. But whatever. So they all go to this house, and the housekeeper is really strange. All the townspeople nearby are really strange, and they all are like, nothing good ever happens here, and you want to stick around here, and everything is bad here, and they're like, something bad. So it's all very ominous, and that's, like, well done in the sense of, like, it's poorly done because none of it's later explained, but it's well done in the way that it makes you feel slowly more and more, like, worried that, like, oh shit, what are they gonna find in this house? So the main character, if there is one, isn't actually the guy assembling these people. It's the girl who, like, experienced something that I think was telekinetic. It was something to do with something unexplained. I forget and I don't care. I read this yesterday, but I don't remember and I don't care. Her name's Eleanor, and her mother died recently, and, like, her whole life was pretty much occupied by taking care of her ailing mother. And now that mother's dead, she's kind of finally free, but she's never actually established a life for herself. She doesn't have friends, she doesn't have interests, her whole life was taking care of her sick mother. So she's kind of an awkward introvert, and her being with these people in this house for the first time is, like, her first outing ever. And so she, like, her relationship with everything that's going on is a little, like, strange because she's a little strange. And again, if the book had been just about that, about a young woman who's been so sheltered and so hidden from society that this encounter kind of breaks her, just being in this remote house that with these people, like, that makes her lose her mind, and that was what this book was about, just that, I think this would be really a really great book. But it's actually, like, a supernatural type of book where there are actual ghosts haunting Hill House, and the housekeeper keeps saying things that are very strange, and I kept thinking that some of it would be explained. In the way, I mean, a ghost story would always leave something unexplained. That's what makes it creepy at the end, and I'm fine with that. But nothing really is ever explained. Like, there's this backstory given to sort of the tragic history of the house, i.e. the sisters that owned it and fought over it, and then how the one sister ended up living there with a companion, and then left the house with the companion, but then the sister who was alive fought the companion for rights to the house, and then the companion, like, killed herself because she was stressed over it, and, like, basically that's, like, the story of the house. That ever since then, people keep, like, dying near the house. Anyone who's tried to own it, people, whenever they've been in the house, they leave immediately, and they never say why, but it's clear, like, people just, like, flee the house. So you keep thinking, like, you'll find out kind of more why that is. And the housekeeper keeps saying very, not just bizarre things, but very specifically bizarre, i.e. that, like, I have agreed to do this, and I have to do this at this time. Like, they question her on it, and are like, well, can you wait, or can you do it later? And she's like, I have to do this at this time. This goes here, I do this at this time. Like, it has to be that way. And you get this sense that the house requires that, or the ghosts require that, or there's something to the specificity of that. So I kept waiting to find out some part of that, but we don't ever find anything out. She's just weird, I guess? And then the hauntings themselves are fairly eerie, but, like, not very eerie. There's, like, some knocking on doors, some writing on the walls that's unexplained. What's frankly the most creepy is the personalities of these people and how they turn on each other. So again, if this book was more like Lord of the Flies, in that it's about the people, it's about, like, if it was just the framing device was that some man decided to investigate this old house because he heard it was haunted, and then he invites some other people, and we need a better explanation for who he's inviting and why, but that aside, invites some people to this house, and that just by being in such an isolated, creepy place, that they all, this kind of starts wearing them all down, and they all kind of start turning on each other, and they kind of start maybe doing weird things that people don't normally do in normal circumstances. If that's what it was about, I'd be, like, super into it. And the way it's written, it almost feels like it wants to be telling a story like that, where it's more about the people, but we're still shoehorning in the hauntings and then not explaining the hauntings. So, like, by the end, Eleanor, like, full-on loses her mind because she thinks, like, the house belongs to her and she belongs to the house. She's, like, laughing maniacally about how she cannot leave it and it's part of her and she's part of it, and that she can, like, hear and sense every part of the house, even the part she's not in. Which doesn't seem, I mean, it is crazy, but it seems crazy in the way of, like, an actual haunting, because she can sense who's in every room, which you know, a crazy person can't magically do that. So that's not just being crazy. And then when she leaves, she like crashes her own car. And we're meant to be unnerved by the fact that at the very last second, she's like, wait, why am I doing this? Which again, makes it seem more like a haunting than like a crazy person. But it's a haunting. So again, if this book was basically just like being in isolation in close quarters with some people with some strange ideas, and especially this like one introverted girl who's never ever been around people before, that this is too much for her mind to deal with and it breaks her and she ends up killing herself, I'd probably give this 5 stars. Because some of the characterization, some of the sort of the specificity of how these people are kind of melting down and how they're kind of starting to snipe at each other and how they don't, like, how they can seem kind in 1 minute and rude the next. There's a lot of elements to it that seem really well done, but it's the haunting factor that ruins it. Because if you're going to do this haunted ghost story, then I need that to be fleshed out more. The whole story seems to be focusing on these character dynamics, and then it remembers all of a sudden that, oh yeah, this is a haunted house story, and then we need to have some haunting type things going on. So there's maniacal laughter that's unexplained, door slamming that's unexplained. But the thing that's creepy is the way these people's psyches are melting down. So it's, at the end, there's kind of some offhand comments that almost kind of want to suggest that maybe this was all in Eleanor's head, because there's something about how, because there was previously like blood writing on the wall and blood smeared on Theodora's clothes. So Theodora has been wearing Eleanor's clothes since then, which is an external thing that they've all agreed is happening. But now as Eleanor's leaving, she's like, I can't leave. What are you going to wear? She's like, I don't need your clothes. I don't need them. Like, it's fine. And I guess we're meant to take from that that maybe Eleanor was imagining that Theodora was borrowing her clothes. But that doesn't, like, that's not enough of a, oh shit, it was in her head the whole time kind of thing. It seems more like they're probably just saying it's fine, I'll just wear someone else's clothes. So if that's what it's meant to be, that actually this was all in her head this whole time, the way everything else has happened, it's not told in a way where you could be like, oh man, on retrospect, like, actually, that's totally, like, it might have just been in her head. No, it's told in a way where, like, it really has to have been actually happening with everyone else too. It really doesn't come across as like, oh, it totally could have been in her. No, it's definitely hauntings. And at the end of the book too, it says something about how the house is evil and the house is haunted. So I don't know what I'm meant to get out of this. Is it a haunted house story where it's just like a haunted house and these ghosts are doing things to people, making them crazy? Or is it really about the psyches of these people and how like one of them just like loses it and kills herself because she's crazy? It wasn't really either one enough to be good. And that's what was so frustrating about it. And then, I mean, this, it takes place in like the 50s or 60s. So there's some like really unfortunate kind of characterization of like the delicate, frail females and like the men who were the sensible, rational ones. And then the professor's wife being so annoying and obnoxious and insistent. And like, I really wanted her to die. I was like, kind of ghost, please kill her. It wasn't, the hauntings weren't creepy because the book didn't really seem to be concerned that much with the hauntings. And at the beginning, when it's like this whole idea of the doctor kind of debunking things, but also that was unclear too. It seemed like he was a believer and that this whole degree in anthropology was just to like make it seem legit, but he's really a believer. But he's also done the work of researching everything and looked into how the house is constructed in a way that will mess with your head, that it's not necessarily a ghost. It's just that everything is kind of like off kilter, which would explain why doors slam, because like they're, you know, everything's at an angle, which would make doors slam, that it's all kind of built circuitously and in a confusing way, kind of like the Winchester Mystery House. He even references the Winchester Mystery House, kind of saying that it's just built in a way that it's going to like mess with your mind. So it's building in all of this doubt about how your things play tricks on your eyes and like that's not real. And then the fact that the main character, Eleanor, is kind of like a little nuts, you're like, okay, so maybe some of this is imagined. But a lot of it really couldn't just be imagined. So I don't know what it's trying to do. I don't know if it's trying to creep me out as like a, this is really a truly haunted house and there are dark, mystical, occult forces at work, or the real ghost here, the real monster here is the human psyche. Because it didn't really do either thing. It tried to do both a little bit. And I guess it's like a choose your own adventure. But you kind of have to pick a lane, dude. You have to really lean into either this is a haunted house, make it truly, truly haunted, and then I need more explanations for these little clues you left, because there isn't an explanation for the hauntings. So like, we get this, the whole, the sisters fighting over the house and the companion killing herself, but the hauntings are like laughter of a child and there's nothing about like a child having tragically died in the house. That's not part of the history. So that's never explained. It's just like a, well, children laughing in the night is inherently creepy. So the haunting will just be inherently creepy. But it doesn't work. Like, you need to actually explain something about like what the heck is going on. And all these things that the housekeeper was saying about how I have to do this at a certain time and I have to be here before, like I have to leave before it's dark and I have to do this, this, and this at this time and this is how it has to be. You need to explain that. You can't just do that. It's, why is that there otherwise? It's just like, it doesn't know what it wants to be. I don't know how many other way to say it. And the characters themselves are less interesting for the fact that a lot of what would be interesting about it is explained as a haunting. You can't have the twist be that it's actually haunted, but the twist also possibly be that it maybe wasn't haunted, that it was just in her head. It's both and neither, and it's really, really frustrating. And for that reason, it's bad. So like, yeah. I guess when I was reading it, I was like, if this was like The Woman in Black, which I found to be genuinely creepy and chilling, and it is very similar in the sense of it's this, I mean, he's by himself, but he's somebody going to a house and the house is the site of a haunting. And he learns more and more about the history of the house and the history of this like woman in black who's haunting it and why she would be like haunting it. And the way in which she's haunting it aligns with her story and his experience of this like ghostly apparition aligns with her story. And it makes sense in its own supernatural way, which makes it really satisfying because it's still the fact that the supernatural can never truly be explained because you're like, why is this phenomena exist at all? Because ghosts are like, are they real? But the way the ghost is operating, if you accept that it's real, makes its own kind of sense. Whereas in The Haunting of Hill House, you get the kind of creepy backstory of the house, but the creepy backstory of the house has almost nothing to do with the way that it's being haunted. Like, none of the hauntings are explained by that backstory. So pick a different backstory then, I guess, if you want the hauntings to be like this. Or then you could have, again, a Lord of the Flies, Wuthering Heights type of situation where nothing's supernatural. It's just that the story is about how crazy people can get in given the right circumstances. So this book could have been fantastic if it picked one of those things. But it seemed like it couldn't decide what it wanted to be and was just like, ugh. It'll be kind of both, and you guys will decide, and it'll be brilliant, because I didn't do either one. Apparently that worked. A lot of people think it's a classic. I did not find it scary. I did not find it creepy. I did not find it earth-shattering or groundbreaking or really anything. I found it a bit tedious, frankly, and I was worried picking it up, because I was house-sitting in a house where I was by myself and cat-sitting, so there would be, like, the noises of cats in the middle of the night, and I was worried if I read this by myself at night, that the rest of the night I'd be like scared shitless. But that did not happen. I was really disappointed by how not scared I was. So yeah. Let me know in the comments down below if you've read The Haunting of Hill House, how you felt about it, if you did read it. I assume that you know something about it if you made it this far in the video or you don't plan to read it. And again, a lot of people love it and I kind of genuinely would like someone to explain to me what makes this so great. I looked up some reviews for that very reason. As soon as I finished it, I was like, can someone shed a light on why this is considered amazing? So I genuinely did look up some like reviews to try to see like what people were praising about it. And it tended to be vague things like, oh, it's just truly like terrifying and truly well executed and truly bone chilling. And I was like, how? In what way? Or again, vague praises like, this defined the genre and it's a classic for a reason. And I'm like, what reason? Please tell me the reason because I don't see it. I don't get it. Let me know in the comments down below how you felt about that book, how you feel about books like it, if you've read The Woman in Black, if you liked that better because I did, if you have books to recommend to me because you were disappointed with this one and you found one that was better, that was like it, then let me know. I post videos on Saturdays, so like and subscribe, and I'll see you next Saturday.